Now, after we made wudu, which is ablution, washing certain parts of our body as preparation for the salah, the prayer, now there is other aspect have to be taken in consideration before your prayer. As example, you should be covered. Certain parts of your body have to be covered. As example, my shoulders have to be covered. My private parts, which from the navel to the knee, have to be covered. Taking the proper clothes for the prayer is very necessary. Also making sure that the time is in. You could not pray before the time. Also the direction for the prayer. You have to take the proper direction towards the Kaaba to make your salah. It is very important that you place a sutra in front of you. A sutra can be anything with a height, which you're going to place it in front of you as a barrier or partition to put it in front of you to stop people of cutting in front of you while you're making salah. After taking these things in consideration, time-wise, purification-wise, body cover, make sure the place that you perform in your prayer on it, it is clean, pure, no impurity on it. A mat, a rug, a towel, anything will be sufficient for you to perform your prayer. Now I'm ready to perform my prayer. And the first thing that I'm going to do is preparing and getting my intention ready for the prayer. It's the act of the heart, has nothing to do with the tongue. You don't say your intention, but you have your intention ready in the heart. Now facing the direction for the salah, and now after you got your intention in your heart, you're going to raise your hands, the two hands, facing the direction of the Qibla. Your body, your hands, your feet. My feet is not open wide, not close to each other, but it's going to be with the angle even to my shoulders and my toes facing the Qibla. So now I'm ready for the prayer. I raise my hands in the level of my shoulders or maximum to this ending of my ear. And by raising the hands, you're going to make takbirat al-ihram, saying Allahu Akbar to start your prayer. Now, Allahu Akbar. You're going to put the right hand over the left hand. The hand, the wrist, and the arm. And you take both of them and you rest them in your chest. And after this, by putting this here, you start saying the opening dua. You can choose between many dua by saying, as example, سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك وتبارك اسمك وتعالى جدك ولا إله غيرك. Your eyes should be looking to the place of your prostration. With your forehead goes down, this is where your sight will be focusing during the prayer. After this, you will say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. After this, you recite the Fatiha. All the above, you be saying it inward. For purpose of teaching, I'm only saying it out loud. Like, Allahu Akbar. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك وتبارك اسمك وتعالى جدك ولا إله غيرك. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. He's saying it to yourself. And you start reading the Fatiha by saying, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. If a morning prayer, you will say out loud the Fatiha. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين Ameen. After finishing the Fatiha, you may choose any chapter from the Quran and recite it after this by saying, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفره إنه كان توابا. Now you will go to the bound down position which we call it ركوع. And this by raising your hand to the side facing the Qibla, the direction of the prayer. And you will say الله أكبر and you will move down to the position of ruku'. It is very important to notice that your back, your head, everything to be leveled. Now your arm are straight, your fingers are on the calf of your knee. You see? Spreading the fingers on the knee, holding on the calf. Now your head down with your back, everything level. And this is ruku', which you recite in this position. Subhana Rabbiyal Azeem. Subhana Rabbiyal Azeem. Subhana Rabbiyal Azeem. You will say this inward. You don't say it loud. Only for